Here we go.
I mean, I don't even need to listen to that. Who streamed more, Madonna or Ariana Grande? Isn't Ariana Grande like got streaming tattooed on her neck somewhere? It's like she's like the streaming master. Who is better at karate, Mr. Miyagi or Ted Lasso? What's up, guys? My name is Paul Blair, professionally known as DJ White Shadow. I'm a Grammy-winning producer, songwriter, artist. Usually my job is to write songs or to play songs for people, but today my job is to show you how to use this incredible app called FanLabel. And I'm going to run this thing down and try and pick the best song, the one that streamed the most this week. Oh, snap! This one is songs produced by yours truly, DJWS, Paul Blair. All right, first one's called Sexy Body. I've heard all these before, by the way. First one's called Sexy Body by Pitbull and Jennifer Lopez. This is a good song. This didn't get the shine that it deserved, that record. There was a couple good songs on that record. But, like, the album, there was politics going on with the album, and it didn't get pushed as hard as it should. There's, like, should have been, like, a big record. You know, right people, right time. I listen to it now. I'm like, oh, this is really well put together. It sounds good. It's like still timely. Like I could play it in the club right now and it would do something. Right. But why can't I play it in the club right now? Because nobody knows it because the machine didn't put it into the lexicon. I don't run the machine. So why'd you do that? Off the Stars Born soundtrack by Lady Gaga. I wrote this with my friends Mark and Nick when we were on tour for Joanne. We were writing these songs for Stars Born. Applause by Lady Gaga. This is one of the biggest Lady Gaga songs out there, I think. I can't remember the exact numbers for things, but I think it's a big one. As a matter of fact, the hook to that song got written, and we were throwing it away. She was throwing it away. She didn't want to use it. It was, like, not on the first pitch for the record. Whenever you make a song, album, you got to go in and pitch it to the label. So we were doing it at Jimmy's house. And Dave... You know, you're preparing in your mind, like, what to play and how to go through and what the story of the record is. It's like a giant presentation. And so when we went to Jimmy's house to play the record, I had to bring that record with me and play it out of, like, be like, there's one more song. And because she didn't want to include it. We played it because I knew it was the strongest song out of all of them. And so did Jimmy. And so we played it for the whole radio team and the promo team and everybody was like, this is a great song. And then she was like, oh, this is a great song. So then we had to go back and record it. But it was just the, you know, memory is a funny thing, right? Like, it's like you tell yourself a story for like an amount of time and like, this is my story. It's not her story. And I think she readily admit this. We both have the same problem, but like whenever she hates something, it's usually like a hit record. Because like instinctively, like you know it's like really gonna be really popular. And so you're like, ah, it's too right down the middle. Like it is what it is. I hate that. And so then it's like, and I do the same thing because that's why we get along, I think. But I think at the beginning, that's why it went into the back burner. Because it was so pop, you know, like so obviously like big that we were just both like, you know, whatever. Born This Way by Lady Gaga. This album just hit like 10 years this year. It's 10 years old. I was reading a poll where it was like the top 100 LGBTQ songs of all time, and it's number 2 behind I'm Coming Out by Diana Ross. So that's a pretty remarkable accomplishment. Like when we were making it, I love that song. I mean, I love this. Every song on this list is like fantastic songs. But like when I was making it, it was like, this is so positive. This is so great. And like, blah, blah, blah. When this gets out there, we get a song about this on the radio. And I think that song was number 1 on Billboard for like 7 weeks or something like that. Maybe 11 weeks, like longer than 1 week, you know? So it made this monster impact and was able to change, shift culture, even in a way that I can't comprehend sometimes. But I'll hear the production of that, and I probably have 100 plus versions of that song on my computer. that I haven't opened since 2010. But I probably literally have 100 different versions of that song, different kind of iterations of where we were in the process. Some of them I loved, some of them I didn't like, some of them whatever. And, like, I'll hear that song. First of all, part of, like, the way that my mind works is I can listen to a song and only hear the hi-hats through the whole song. Like, it's the way that my brain works. It's always worked that way. Even if I listen to a Fleetwood Mac song, I can hear just the drum fills. Like, that's it's part of, like, my whatever, weird gift. And so every time I listened to Born This Way for the longest time, all I could hear were these certain parts that I know are wrong, that I don't like, and it's all I could hear. So it was like I missed the whole entire point, you know what I mean? So it takes a long while to be like, shit, why did we settle on that synth instead of the other one that I can still hear from 10 years ago, you know? So anyway, but the message of the song and the presentation of the song are fantastic, you know what I mean? And Sex Dreams by Lady Gaga. We wrote this song in a hotel room for 14 hours. We stopped writing it, it's 8 a.m. I was so tired that I was delirious. We were in Europe somewhere, and like in a room, like in a round table like this. And there was like so many times where I was like looking at Dave, because Dave has to record everything. So like Dave's the centerpiece. So we're all kind of like dancing around Dave because he's got to be stationary. And she's recording, and then it's an idea, and then it's another idea. And like when you're running through ideas, it can become exhausting. Like especially when everybody's got like different ideas. And then her process, once she has an idea, like she has to get it out. It's like a sneeze, you know? So it's like, sometimes it's boom. And then sometimes it's like, well. And then sometimes it's like, holy cow. Like this is like a marathon stretch of time trying to finish something. All right, so I got to pick what streamed the most last week. And I'm going to say it's between Applause and Born This Way. Son of a biscuit. I'm going to screw this up and everybody's going to make fun of me. Oh, I knew it was a second place. I thought that if I picked it, it was going to be first place, but it's not. How much is the difference? Oh, it's a lot more. Damn. I couldn't remember. I was trying to think about the numbers, if it actually streamed more, Applause streamed more, or Born This Way streamed more. I know Born This Way is a more popular song, but I think I read one time that Applause streamed more, so I was going off the data and not my instinct, which honestly, like any track, this sounds like a really probably stock answer, but for different reasons, you can't really pick a favorite, like picking a favorite kid. Sometimes one of them's your favorite, sometimes the other one's your favorite, sometimes neither of them are your favorite. So like, Artpop as a whole record in general was a very weird time, like in life, and like a very weird time with things outside of the record. So it's like now I go back and look on it and you forget all the crap that was happening like during that time. But like there were 5 years where like I didn't even want to listen to it because like so much bad stuff was going on. Even though people enjoyed it and it was like so great to see people enjoying it and it was like really, you know, well received and like this great thing. But like from a standpoint of like sitting there, you know, I'm sure people at Burger King don't like Whoppers as much as the average, you know, person walking in to eat a hamburger, you know what I'm saying? Inside of your body, because of thousands of years of evolution, you tend to remember the bad things instead of the good things, right? Like for me, it takes a really long time to get to a point where it's like, oh, I just remember the good things. Because there was a lot of tears shed and a lot of like things going wrong like during that time. And I associated even really positive, happy songs with like a really negative time. A lot of sharks in the water. A lot of blood in the water, a lot of sharks in the water at that time. So it's a tough album.